dynamics of music.
Mm-hmm. Ghetto Boys and Floetry. Yeah.
Absolutely. Those totally, are two, entirely, both ends of the spectrum, that is.
Right. Entirely mm-hmm. different, you know, stuff altogether. Let's see. What else is going on in Chicago? Because, you know, Chicago is a festival city.
We are. Is it festival season approaching?
Festival season
has
really started to kick off. Like, I know, for instance, Dancing in the Park is about to start, and that's where it's like a lot of salsa. Mm-hmm. Salsa music. They even incorporate some swing music and stuff into it too.
They always have the movies in the park. I don't know how movies well that's been going with the rain situation, but you know, that's always
yeah
a
the
thing.
Rain like, situation. Because you know, there's 400 noted. This sounds crazy. There are 400 noted neighborhoods in Chicago, and all of those neighborhoods pretty much have schedules.
Right.
So what's on tap? Like Pilsen has already had their food truck. That was the early part of June.
I missed that.
You missed it. You also probably missed the Chicago Rib Fest, which was last week.
That was last week.
Rob, did you go?
You did?
Yeah. Was it worthwhile? No. Not really. You weren't overly impressed? Okay.
Yeah, I did miss that. I knew that was last week.
It was expensive? Well, it's like the taste of Chicago is expensive now.
It is.
You know, I've got the tickets. And I've gotten to the point that I don't even know anymore. If I even enjoy it anymore. It's like so many people, and the food to me mm-hmm. is not all that great anymore. Like, I don't really feel it's truly the taste of Chicago. I don't think you're getting things on the fringe that you would go there for. But this weekend, starting on the 18th, is the Puerto Rican Festival, which is in Humboldt Park. That's Thursday, Friday, 3 to 10, Saturday and Sunday, noon to 10. It's free admission. This is the 33rd annual celebration of Puerto Rican culture.
Wow.
So that's going on.
Wow.
The Six Corners Barbecue Fest, if you are a rib person, is going on. You want to try that out? That's June 19th to the 21st.
Yes.
That's at Portage Park, Milwaukee Avenue, Irvin Park Road, and Cicero. So it's like, that's what's called the Six Corners.
Mm-hmm.
That's Saturday from noon to 10, Sunday from noon to 8, free admission. But that's interesting. But they ask for a $5 gate donation to benefit local artists.
That you don't have to give it.
You don't have to, but you're kind of a heel if you don't.
You know, sometimes you gotta be a heel.
The Taste of Randolph is going on the 19th to the 21st. That's the West Loop. It takes place between 900 and 1200 West Randolph Street. Today it's 5 to 10, Saturday and Sunday, noon to 10. No admission, even though they suggest a $10 donation. I'm starting to like these donations.
See what I mean?
Yeah. It's a big street festival, though, in the West Loop. It's going into its 19th year.
Yes.
And it covers everything. It's very cross-cultural. It's a mixture of different kind of foods, artisans, musical offerings. That's going on. And then the Gold Coast Art Fest is going on the 20th to the 21st.
Noted.
And that's in Butler Field and Grant Park. So pretty much that's by Eastman Rose Street and South Lakeshore Drive.
Mm-hmm.
That's from 10 to 6 p.m. on both days. Free, but a $5 donation.
All right, with the donation. Just charge $5 and keep it.
Then the Green Music Fest is going on the 20th and 21st. That's in Wicker Park at Damon Avenue. It's noon to 10 p.m. on those 2 days. Obviously, all types of different music. Once again, it's free, but they'd like $5 from you.
All right, I'm just going to start giving everybody $5. I'm just going to come with the mindset that everything costs $5, and that's what we're going to do.
Yeah, so lots of different festivals going on.
And not to forget our Love and Heroes. That is also this weekend.
That's right, at Harold Washington Cultural Center. Check that out. All right, let's take a break, and we'll come back, and we'll get into our segment, Where to Go and People to See. And then this particular segment, we're featuring Sybil Holloway. Stay tuned. Okay. We got to call her.
Just a foolish dreamer, but I don't care. 'Cause I know my happiness is waiting somewhere. I'm searching for that silver lining, horizons that I've never seen. Oh, I'd like to take just a moment and dream my dream. Oh, dream my dream. Oh, oh, the stars at night. I'd like to know the taste of honey in my life. In my life. Well, I've shed so many pains, and I've played so many games. Oh, but everyone finds the right way somehow, somewhere, someday.
Welcome back to the Maya Kai Show. We're in the home stretch of the show. Myself here and Nikki Braden.
Yes, yes, y'all.
That's right. You are listening to Smooth 90.5 FM HD Radio, of course. Also via Sirius XM Channel 432, or perhaps you're streaming worldwide at Live365 or iHeartRadio.com. Either way, you're tuned in to radio that never looked
so good.
We're so vain. Anyways, that'll be the next time. You're so vain. Anyways, so our final segment is where to go and people to meet. And actually, we have on Sybil Holloway, who is my first guest for this segment because she is such a dynamic young woman. Welcome to the Maya Kai Show. Sybil, how are you?
Hi, how are you? Thank you for having me, Maya.
Of course, you're no stranger to the show. You're new here, but no stranger to my show. As we talked about in the last...
Hi, Sybil.
Yes. Was founded back in 2008 with the sole purpose of supporting African-American businesses and enterprises through social and non-social networking. And you have an event coming up on this Saturday, and it's the fourth annual Black Men Stand Up event honoring African-American male entrepreneurs. Tell us a bit about the event, Sybil.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear you, Maya. What about the event?
Tell us a bit about the upcoming event on Saturday.
Oh, tell us about, okay, it'll be at the Witherspoon Law Group, a black-owned law group, about four men. They own a law group, four law groups within the country. So we're going to showcase the law group here in Chicago, 3855 South Low. And this particular event, I showcase black men in business. So there will be about 15 different black men that will be highlighted at this particular event.
Wow, so this is your fourth annual you do. What's the criteria you put together to determine, you know, who you should showcase for this event?
For some reason, I'm having a hard time hearing you. I'm so sorry.
How do you, you said you have about 15 different gentlemen that you're going to be showcasing for this. How do you decide, since this is your fourth annual one you're doing, how do you decide who you want to kind of present in this forum?
How do I decide who's going to be, like, highlighted?
Yes. Yes.
Well, basically, you know, since I've been doing this for almost 7 years, they've been to my events, they know how many people will be there, and they want to be recognized, so they'll come to me. So I really, what I do is kind of look at men in business that offer something that all of us can use. So I have a few doctors, Dr. Tinsley, a dermatologist and a plastic surgeon. I have a chiropractor, I have lawyers. I have a man that owns an auto store. I have Fleetwood Restaurant, Norman's Bistro, Batter and Berries. Really different black businesses owned by men that do something that we all can use. And they can be showcased and they can gain more exposure.
Wow, and that's definitely a very diverse group of people that you're representing, everything from a plastic surgeon to someone who's a restaurant owner. That's
sure.
Definitely it. So now, obviously, you said that it's at the Witherspoon Law Group.
Yes, it is.
Now,
right here in the Bridgeport area in Chicago.
Right, it's at 3855 South Lowell. Now, Sybil, your events draw hundreds of people. This must be a heck of a big law office.
Yes, and I hope I see you there, right?
Of course, you know, look, I don't think I've missed one in a long time. I don't think I've missed one for a while. Because, I mean, there's such great events. The networking is amazing. The people who come out. The fact that you've built it up to this. And I was kind of giving a little bit about your story to my listeners. But tell my listeners, what made you decide to create Sib's Breakfast Club?
Well, I watched my father. He owned a grocery store, game room, fish market, and a restaurant. So I watched him and everything that he had to deal with as a black man in business, and he had so much help around him from the other entrepreneurs around him. And I watched the way they worked together, and I saw that none of them could do it alone. They all needed each other. And that's kind of where I got my concept. My sister and I got the concept when we started Tiff's Breakfast Club. So this is just a way of us all helping each other. And you can't really have a business without exposure. So by me bringing 200 or 300 people into your business, it allows them to get residual business, and we continue to recycle the black dollar and help each other.
And so far, it seems like you've had fantastic success with the business that you featured. A lot of people come out, a lot of people. And here's what's key. It isn't just people coming out just for the heck of it. It's really people coming out that are active consumers that will spend money. And I think that's the key element, because anybody can have a party. Right. But it's one thing to really put together a clientele of people that will frequent the business and will appreciate what you do. And I think that's amazing. So how did you – so you had the idea. How did you manage to filter people into it?
You know what? Actually, it's really like when I started it – Maya, it was just 20 or 30 of my friends, and we were hanging. I said, come out to this restaurant, because nobody really knows about it, and it's so good. And then I just started doing it monthly, and then every other person was telling their friend about it, and it just became this thing, and it turned into an organization. I guess based on the needs. And then I had so many business owners calling me, like, how can you help me? How can you bring people here? And I just love it, and it's a lot of work, but it's so rewarding.
For those who haven't been and they want to come, do you have to buy tickets in advance, or is this like a free event?
For this event, it's open bar, brunch included. We'll have 3 live bands. We'll have a pop-up art gallery. So in 60 days. So it's $25 in advance and $35 at the door. Okay. And you get so much for it. So much talent.
Any live performances with this?
I'm sorry?
Any live performances? I know sometimes you'll have live
artists. We have Simone Green.
Miss Simone.
I think I've heard of her before.
I might know her.
He's played on Empire. Yes, we do.
Okay.
Yes, it's going to be there. And Bernard Burton.
Okay.
Singer, yes. So we're going to have an acoustic set. 3 different artists.
Wow, so you get DJs, acoustic artists, there's food, all kinds of different things.
Yeah, Dane Hunt, Brian Estelle, we have a lot of 60 DJs, Jay Armani, it's going to be a terrific event.
It always is. And you said if they want to get tickets, they can get them through Eventbrite?
Yes, you can. And actually what you could do is log on to my website, and the link is right there, and that's www.sibsbreakfastclub.com.
And that's SIBS, correct?
Exactly. Thank you. Mm-hmm.
And your website actually is pretty comprehensive, because it's an extension of the event, because you have a directory of businesses and things like that as well, too, right?
Yes, exactly.
So there you have it. If you're looking for something, she's got a whole directory there of businesses that you can check out and frequent. But your events have always known to be very good, Sip. So I'm looking forward to coming out tomorrow and checking this out. I'm
10 to 3, right? 10 to 3 people.
So come out and support these black men tomorrow.
Yes, we will.
We absolutely will. All right.
10 to 3 people.
10 to 3. And go to her website, Sip's Breakfast Club, to get the link to Eventbrite to purchase your tickets. It will be money well spent, to say the least.
I co-sign.
All right, Sip, thank you for calling.
Thank
in. We appreciate
you.
It.
I'll see you in the morning, Maya.
See you in the morning.
Bye-bye.
That is Sybil Holloway, who is the founder of Sib's Breakfast Club, which really focuses on trying to create exposure for black businesses.
Sure.
You know, she's really big in recycling the black dollar, and it comes from her personal experience.
Mm-hmm.
You know, her dad, you know, owning businesses.
Entrepreneur.
Right there, she saw that without the support of people around you, having a collection, you know, a network, it's hard.